Hey guys, you Rook Coopers, and welcome back to my 5016 Liverpool career mode, where if you missed my stream today, I finished off season 2, and now we're beginning season 3. The first game is a home game against the Hammers, West Ham United. And let's jump in and do it. Tiemann's coming in because Coutinho picked up a train injury. It's only 7 days, so it's not the end of the, it's not something to get too worried about, but he should be fully fit in time for the second game of the season in the league. And I have no problem playing Tiemann will probably play a lot more games than he has as this in past seasons this season, because he's now 83 rated, so he's the same rating as Jordan Henderson. So expect to see more of the young Belgian. Maybe at some point he'll become a first team star, it's very possible. Well, Henderson is clinging on to the spot right now, but you know, Tiemann is always playing very good. And if it comes to it, I will have no problems dropping him. So I like Henderson as a player. He's a great player. He's done a lot for in the first two seasons. But I'm not here to debate that I wouldn't be better off putting in Tim when Henderson's what, 27, 28? And then Tim is just much younger. Has a higher potential, and this makes sense if I put Tiemann in the first team, but I'm not going to do that until I think it's the right time. And probably it happened when Tiemann goes up to 84. Royce! Straight Adrian. That was fantastic, Marco. Presenting Carol Cayute. Payet. Noble. Cresswell. Bale stops that little attack from the Hammers, and now he's gonna negate the counter-attack. Whip it in. Correa. And there we go. Angel Correa scores the first goal of the season. A throw. The ball back off them. Here we go. Correa whips it. And then Cayute does a very good job getting in the way of that cross.
out for a through me. Hope I fail. Here's Correa. Come on, get the crossing this time. Nope, Reed blocked it this time. Mars hurts Correa. Oh, what a goal, Adrian. And he didn't have a hope of stopping it. It's a thunderous strike from Correa. Yeah. Good header pass by Ename. Or he's probably going to get an assist for that. I assume he will anyway. And even though he was close, I don't think there was anything he could realistically do to stop that. I mean, you know, he gave it his best attempt, which you gotta give him credit for, which I do. Adrian's a very good coach. Shot came straight to Correa and turned into a pass. It's not what I had in mind. Henderson. Neymar, who will be playing his first full season in England, joining in January last season. Tip Neymar is one of the guys who's probably going to be up there with favorites to get the golden boot come the end of the season. Maybe Tielemans will be up there. Or is he's off the mark? Neymar, I passed it to Correa for the hat trick. Like, I could have easily shot with Neymar, but I didn't. The ball fell to Tim since I struck it in well. It went in. He always gets really involved whenever I play him, which is more what I consider him as a definite long-term replacement for Henderson. It's just a question of when is he going to take that spot. I truly believe it's going to be this season. Fanuel Klein! Oh, that would have been one for the record books. So I guess if that had gone in. Oh, the shot, to be honest. I can at least be given credit for that. Royce. Oh, Tompkins, the check. And it was good enough to stop, get the ball off Royce. And then when Royce went to stop it from going out of place. Or what probably would have been a corner, to be honest. Pumpkin's got it clear. Falling in a Valencia. I heard they want to give it back to you. Yeah, that's probably fine with me. Or it's Nathaniel Klein. I know you're not seeing things. Yes, De Bruyne did go to Man City. It's a few seasons behind. I think that just happened in game, right? He's been at sea for months now. But in real life. Can Neymar get off the mark? Yes, he can now. The post. But they all count. Of the Copa Europe final, which I'm probably going to sim, to be honest. It doesn't really matter. I mean, I do get prize money for it, but it's nothing significant. Plus, I know, well, I'm actually looking to make signing, because Danny Ings has been sold to Newcastle. I got an offer that was just too good to refuse. From Newcastle, like, gave me 30 million, which definitely wasn't expecting from Newcastle of all things. But then I don't think Newcastle have money. I know Newcastle have money, they just don't spend it, especially on permanently proven. That's one of that's what all Newcastle fans complain of, is that when they do make a signing, it's never anyone that can really help them in the Premier League. It's usually an unproven guy from a different league. So, there you go. Hold your. He's in the game. Him? Mike Ashley is actually listening to you. How he did that, I have no idea. Sign his striker to partner Divock Origi on the second team. As you can see, made a cheeky little sign from Arsenal. Well, I signed the Arsenal youngster Matlin Niles, I think it's pronounced. Actually. Got them for 4 million for some reason. Don't know why. There you go, he's already up to 75, right? It's a bit disappointed that my backup keeper didn't go up. I was expecting them both to go up. They just didn't. Oh, yeah, I meant to, forgot about that. That would have been costly. I'd forgotten to give Rain the new contract that they asked for. They almost completely forgot about it, to be fair. Which is my bad. Here we go. I think I actually gave him more than he was asking for. Which was okay. some of the seeing these players not interested in letting any of them leave. Get Moreno to a new contract as well. I don't know if he'll sign that. I hope he'll sign it. He freaking better sign it. I'd be pissed if he doesn't. Who else is low on contracts? Bale. So, someone I can't afford to lose. No idea what I'm giving him 5%, but there you go. He doesn't score that many goals, so it's okay. And Royce too. Wow, they're all down. Need to do 1 year on their contract. Yeah, I'm not interested in seeing them depart. Give them all to new contracts. Sort them out. I renewed the rest of those contracts off camera. Nah, here we go. We've gotten some plays. Nacho from Manchester City would be perfect replacement for Danny Ings, only one rating lower. Nah, 4 years younger. 5 years younger, sorry. 25 Ings was. So if he'll accept that will be fantastic. There's another option here. Wow, he wants 35 grand. And again, that's pretty freaking cheap compared to Nacho's freaking 100k. See, I got an offer for 11. Gazelle. Don't know what I'm gonna do with that offer yet. I have made a counter offer that if I do get what I asked for it was actually Bayern Munich who made the offer. If I do get what I asked for, I guess I'd be happy to sell him. You know, not unless I do get what I seek. Out of the deal. Let's hope the transfer one of those guys can go through before the cup game. Barcelona said that's unacceptable. They want 25 million for Andres Silva, someone I used in my Borussia Mönchengladbach career mode. He was very good. With 25 million. It's pushing it a bit. You see, I also got a bid for Ings from Hoffenheim, but he chose to go to Newcastle, so there's that. We want to make another bid. I really don't see the point in making another bid. Like, if I don't get, I mean, I can always go back to Silva if I don't get, get one of the other players I'm going for. More. Did Bayern accept my counter offer? No, they've come back. They will pay 20 and a half. Hmm. 20 and a half. I gained $5 million on his valuation. Don't remember how much I paid for him. I think that's probably less, to be honest. I don't use him as much. He's pretty fucking pissed at me in that regard. And to be honest, he's competing with Tiedemans for a position I don't really need competition for him. I mean, I have Martin Costa, who can be my alternate to Tiedemans, so he's yours, Byron. I don't know. No beef except taking that. He'll get back to me shortly. They've accepted the $5 million for Burnett, which is fantastic. Squad rotation, will he accept that? Pretty young player, because I'm not gonna get anyone in. There's a million there, sorry. Who the fuck is that? Newcastle are watching YouTube. They're getting someone who actually looks like the true Jordy. He just has a little extra facial hair, which is mad. What's the true Jordy? No. Well, that fucker has a lot of fucking facial hair. What? He rejected Wolfsburg? I didn't even get notice that Wolfsburg had made a bid for him. Whatever. As you can see, I didn't end up getting Kamano, who I got Iturbe instead. See if I can't bring out the, quality that everyone else sees. I see it too, to be honest. It's Herbe. He even got Kamano's number, ironically enough. And brilliant. They beat me in fucking extra time. Fuck you. Fuck your shit. Contracts were accepted by Royce and Brain. Colette is happy. With what, I'm not sure. Right, so do I pick? Realistically, it'd be better to go with Nacho, wouldn't it? Weak in Man City. I got a player who slots right in. To the second team. Him in $14.5 million. That's a bargain. I mean, sir, I could easily sell him on for probably double that. And if he plays well. So yeah. Kelchi Iheanacho. Probably said that wrong, but oh yeah, I guess my wages took a bit of a beating from those other options. Making any more signs, Iheanacho is exactly what I was looking for from the second team. Where the second teams are. Boom! A 79. 279 rated players. Countries. Are you from? Nigeria. So Nigerian and a Belgian. That could be a deadly strike force. There's that will propel me to cup glory, hopefully. Well, I don't know what I'm saying, hopefully it will. just, because I have a lot of contracts that are going to come through there in a second. 50-50, so I don't get any notices that needs to be adjusted. Yep. The first team is up for the game against Sunderland. My third choice keeper didn't accept his contract, that's fine. All the important players did. That's what matters. I don't think I'll need that Ambrose deal now. So sorry. His interest. Your name intrigues me. I will not be signing either of you. What I was looking for from Aiheanacho from Manchester City. Why they sold him to me is beyond me, but yeah, no. That's definitely not fucking happening. I'm not selling Jordan Ibe. Are you daft? I think the game is daft. It might be daft. Almost forgot to put him back in. That would have been a mistake. But it's online in my second game last season as well. He scored a goal against me. It was very disappointing. I am to concede even less goals this season than I did last season. So will not be conceding in this match. It's first and foremost goal. Of course, my goal is, ultimate goal is to win, but I do not want to concede either. So I'll be paying close attention to the main attacks that someone might muster. Foul? What? Oh, but a similar challenge is a foul when it's me tackling him. Brilliant. So off Quates. This for a corner. Take that. The header was pretty pathetic, leads to a goal kick, which I will get with Rain, Henderson, Chris, Bonfield. Will they both grab, but the ball is cleared. Rodriguez. Oh, boom! Ricardo Rodriguez!
came all the way from the fence to score that goal. Oh. Very good goal, Kinsler. From an unlikely score, I am 1-0 up. Hey, it doesn't matter who scores it. That man. And, well, why would it? Why the fuck does it matter?
Goalkeepers could score all my goals for me and I wouldn't give a shit. I'd wonder why he was up. So often, but just that. But that's a bridge I don't think I'll have to cross. Good defensive work there by the. The fourth day. Coutinho took goal scorer last season. First game of the season, Trey wants to get off the mark.
Henderson, almost a goal against his former club for Jordan Henderson.
Rain back to Henderson. Away to Royce. Played all the way back to the keeper just to get the oomph on the fence so someone don't get any funny ideas that they might score in this match. Neymar, good defending by Cortez, gets the block in.
Continue!
Good save by the Sunderland goalkeeper. Let's come to Royce. Rodriguez, Neymar!
Daniel Klein! Can you imagine? Fine, just over the bar, and there's the halftime whistle. Straight into the second half. Don't have time to do the guy. 1-0 up for that Ricardo Rodriguez goal. Coutinho. Correa! He ran straight into Coutinho. Are you blind? No, Nate. How could you have not seen it? And then Ricardo Rodriguez is the player to watch. All my players are very deadly. They've all scored multiple goals. The only person who hasn't scored a goal from he was playing to get something away is the goalkeeper. It's not his job to score goals, he's there to
prevent the opposition from scoring. Don't you dare give a penalty. Oh, thank God. Oh, the patch saved me there. If this was pre-patch, that would have definitely been a fucking penalty. You didn't know it, right? Fail. Gareth Bale, good save by Maroney. Correa! Ooh! That first time, probably should have known. It's a goal kick. Ron Charlie Austin have that. Sunderland. Someone who's been next to their rivals in real life is Charlie Austin. Newcastle could definitely use him. Correa scores again. Three goals already in the... He gets correct. Is it Correa's season? Perhaps. Correa is now 83 rated, so he's no longer the lowest rated outfield player. If he keeps banging goals in like that, he'll be 84 before he knows it. Be fantastic. His growth is, he's growing brilliantly. Makes you wonder, doesn't it? Quickly make a substitution. I think Coutinho has played enough of this match. I'm gonna bring Iheanacho on for his debut. Bring on Tielemans. I did say Tielemans will play a lot this season, and I meant it. Ball there for 2 minutes. Reverse. Neymar! Not a traditional striker number, but okay. He's more of a defender or a goalkeeper number, if I'm being honest. I've seen a striker with a team as their number. 14, I see. Oh, Henderson! Penalty! Oh, Jordan Henderson wins a penalty against his former club. That probably should be a red card. That would have been a goal had Lens not prevented it. Prevented a goal scoring opportunity. Should be a penalty. I'm going to give it to Iheanacho for his first goal. Why not? As long as he can score it, yes he can. And he's no problem being Maroney. Mm-hmm. is his first goal in a little for sure. Hopefully the first of many. Ball to no one in particular. There's the full time whistle. 3-0 win. Turn. That's a comfortable win, and I didn't concede, so I did hit my two goals were achieved in that match. Pretty successful episode, really. Top of the table again. The question is, will the other teams actually make it a race this time? Hopefully they will, or most will be in for another one-sided season. I won't complain either way, but it's better to have competition. We'll have to wait until next episode. Until then, and thanks for watching. Like if you enjoyed, hit subscribe, and then you'll never miss a video. Oh, and until next time, have a very